Episode 83. Apologize. Naturally, Boss Romano was the one who dealt with that hooligan. As soon as he heard Boss Romano's name, the young man exposed Rudy's identity on the forum. When it became obvious that Rudy had deliberately tried to set up Midnight Snack Corner, the netizens were completely enraged. They were furious at Rudy's shamelessness and enraged that he had tried to trick them into doing his bidding. For several days, countless threads attacking Rudy appeared on the forum. So many users flooded the forum that it nearly went offline several times. "We must resolutely resist the Veil Bakery, and we must resist this inhuman beast!" A letter of apology to the Midnight Snack Corner. There were countless such posts. Not only that, angry people had begun showing up to the Veil Bakery in droves. Rudy knew they'd be coming, and his door was tightly shut by the time the first one arrived. He hid in his shop and did not dare to step out.
"I can't believe I was tricked by the likes of you!"
An old man who had bought several dozen eclairs from the shop days before now threw them at the front door as he cursed.
"Open the door! It's useless for you to hide inside! We've already called the police!"
Following closely behind the pastries were expired eggs, rotten vegetables, and moldy pieces of fruit. Everything that could be thrown at the door was. Rudy was little better than a rat in the eyes of the general public. Almost everyone hated him. The Veil Bakery would never be able to stay in business while they remained in the Bayside District. The other shop owners were extremely conflicted over all these happenings. They didn't quite know how to feel, and they couldn't help but remember Aiden's words.
"You guys better remember what you said and did today. When the truth is out, I hope you don't regret it."
Now, the truth has come out. They regretted it very much.
"It's all Rudy's fault. If he hadn't tricked us, we wouldn't have believed all the lies about the Midnight Snack Corner."
In this way, the neighbors who had ridiculed the Midnight Snack Corner threw all the blame on Rudy. That night, the Midnight Snack Corner was packed with people. Almost all the neighbors lowered their heads and came to the Midnight Snack Corner to apologize. However, as they entered, their eyes were drawn to a tall figure sitting in the corner. He was wearing a blue suit and an exquisite grayish-black quartz watch. He was slowly eating a bowl of chicken noodle soup. Everyone knew who he was, but no one dared to approach him. Hood rubbed his hands together.
"Morse, Clara, Aiden,"
he began humbly.
"There seems to have been some misunderstanding between us.
Please forgive us.
We were all bewitched by Rudy.
Aiden, can you ask Mr. K to advertise for us?"
In his heart, Aiden sneered at all of them. He deeply disdained the shamelessness of these neighbors.
"Forgive you?"
Clara suddenly raised her voice as she spat in Hood's face.
"Forgive you for accusing us of a crime we didn't commit? Or forgive you for being kind and not having the heart to call the police to arrest us?"
Clara put her hands on her hips and scolded the neighbors, who listened silently with stooped shoulders, looking defeated and ashamed.